Captain's Log 98.6. The spaceship Indifferent has been sent to search for a freighter ship with a cargo of toys that went missing near a planet, Arigato. Other than a strange message received from someone on the planet calling themselves a sorceress and warning us to stay away, there has been no other communication regarding the lost ship. A landing party is flashing down to investigate.
Captain, we're picking up odd movements 20 yards from our location.
Is it alive?
Inconclusive. It appears to be spherical in shape and composed of polyisoprene.
What the hell is that?
Rubber, Captain.
Just say that then!
Great move. Caught the Giants in time. They were coming with pressure. Tom Brady got rid of it.
What was that? I got a bad feeling about this.
The cosmos, the ultimate boundary. These are the travels of the spaceship Indifferent on a 7-year assignment to discover bizarre new planets, to seek out new aliens, new weirdo cultures, to shamelessly go where no one has gone before.
What is it?
Why, it's just a child's play ball.
Laser guns are inoperative! They never work! This always happens! Switch to hand-to-ball combat!
Captain Mike to Indifferent! Emergency! We need to be flashed up to the ship immediately!
Captain, we can't flash you up right now. The system is down and won't respond.
What do you mean it's down?
Did you try rebooting? That always works for me.
Yes, I tried that. It didn't work. Mr. Roboto is running a diagnostic right now, but so far, nothing.
Well, call the help desk if they can fix it.
Call me as soon as they do. Captain, out.
Fine.
Please hold.
Captain, the Tritector has confirmed that these balls are part of the shipment. The freighter that went missing. But how did they become alive? I believe there's your answer, Captain.
So you dare disobey me? Well, you should have listened, Captain Stooping, because my toys are hungry.
These are the toys from the lost ship we've been looking for. But somehow, you've made them come alive and vicious.
For there are two things I love. A perfectly made martini and toys I can play with. And unfortunately for you, you're the losing opponent.
Nice try, Captain Hawk, but you'll have to do better than that.
Come on, let's head for that higher ground.
Are ahead.
Captain Mike to Indifferent, do you copy? Damn it, I got nothing. I had two bars a second ago.
Who's your carrier?
T-Mobile. We can try and go back to where I had signaled before, but after what happened to Jackson, that could prove to be a fool's errand. What do you think, Mr. T?
Agreed, Captain. I would pity the fool who would even try.
Don't worry. I'm sure at this very moment, Lieutenant Perna has the transporter fixed, and she's going to be flashing us aboard any second.
Thank you for holding. This is Josh. How may I help you?
Our flash transporter system is down, and I need to get it operable right away. We have people waiting.
Slow it down there, Missy. Everything's a fire drill these days since we started supporting this space stuff. First, I need your user ID.
Fine. It's FU2, okay?
Pardon?
It's F as in Frank, U as in under, 2, O as in, O... and K as in Kitty.
Okay, I see you now. So you said your flash transport system is down?
Yes.
Oh, I have an idea. It's a good one too. Have you tried rebooting? That always works for me.
There's no sign of the Sorceress. We've been walking for a while.
Exactly 12.7 minutes, Captain.
Maybe she's gone.
Not likely.
You need to wear a belt.
I've grown bored with this game. It's not challenging anymore. And I need to get my drink refreshed. I'm gonna let my toys finish you off.
So
this is how you get your kicks? With twisted games? You're not bored, you're sadistic.
There's no challenge, Captain. I am bored.
Then we challenge you to a real game, where we know the rules up front, and we have a fighting chance.
Captain!
What's the matter, Sorceress? Afraid of a real challenge?
Very well, Captain Caveman. It might be fun. I accept your challenge.
Indeed, Captain, but perhaps not an improvement.
Hey, she's never by here.
Captain, the Tritector is detecting a large amount of energy radiating from that unusual lamp over there.
I believe it was once called a lava lamp.
Yes, it appears the energy is moving in a peculiar manner. I would need the ship's computer to further analyze this data.
So, Captain, can I offer you and your crewmates a libation before we play?
Let's just get to the game, Sorceress.
I like your enthusiasm, Captain.
Do you have a Sam Adams?
Sure do.
So, are you like her personal bartender or something?
Pays the bills.
Sorceress! The game?
Very well, Captain. Let's get started. You must repeat the pattern of lights. You and your crew as a team versus me. First to break the pattern loses.
And if we win?
You may return to your ship unharmed.
And if we lose?
You must remain here for eternity and entertain me playing board games. I particularly like Candyland.
Fascinating, but quite unappealing.
Well, at least she has a bar.
Let the game begin!
Good times.
I'll go first.
Working again, thanks.
Good. Now, before we end the call, would you like to take a survey on how we...
Corey, contact the captain and tell him the transporter system is back up and working, and we can bring them back aboard.
I'm trying, but it's going straight to voicemail. Here, I'll put it on speaker.
Call me later.
Okay, I think it was blue, red, yellow, red.
Actually, Captain, I think it went blue, orange, green, red.
Dude, you don't even know what you're talking about. It's yellow, blue, red, yellow.
Well, actually, Ensign, according to the color wheel, orange, blue, and red, green are complementary.
Where are you getting orange? There's no orange.
Well, that seems highly illogical.
You suck at this. All right, I got it. Okay, your turn, Sorceress.
All over the nightlight, I've got to forget. On the disco I had
child's play.
She's an exceptional player. It will be difficult to defeat her.
She's got, like, magical powers. Of course she's gonna beat us.
There's no such thing as magic, Ensign.
The 2001 Patriots.
Told you to stay on the ship.
We tried to call you to tell you that the ship's transporter system was working again, but no answer. So we used the ship scanner to locate you and came down to save you.
Oh, excellent! More players to abuse me!
Who's she? Ooh, I like your drink. Is it a grapefruit martini? It's so pink.
What is pink?
Your drink. You know, like the color pink?
Not following.
So, are you guys like open all the time?
Only when the sorcerer's awake.
How often is that?
24 hours a day.
Wow.
Well, it doesn't matter. Where'd you get that outfit?
Oh, I got it at the Space Mall. Yeah, we can go. Oh, it'd be fun. Girls night!
Captain. I believe Lieutenant Perna has given us an edge over our opponent.
She's colorblind. She must be remembering the pattern based on the placement, not on the color.
That would seem likely.
Your turn, Sorceress.
Very well. No! How can this be?
You lose, Sorceress. Now let us go.
Very well. Besides, I have a headache and I need to go lie down. You and your crew may go. And you can come back anytime for a rematch.
Sorceress, I think we've had enough games for a long time. Captain Mike to Indifferent.
Lieutenant Corey here.
Landing party ready to flash up.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Let's go, Ensign.
Yeah. Coming!
5309. What was your name again?
Jenny.
Flash yourself.
I guess I'll have another.
Next time on Star Journey.
Where is he? Where?
Get back! I'll cut him, I swear.
Please don't hurt me.
There is an antidote on the planet below, but it is located in a place fraught with great danger.
We'll form a landing party, go down to the planet, and then we'll retrieve it. The landing party will consist of myself, Mr. T, Ensign Matt, and Crewman Wolf.
Oh, shit.